2021 has provided us with some incredible games for the PlayStation Vita, and all of the games featured in this video can be downloaded, installed, and played on your own modded PlayStation Vita right away. From ports of beloved classics to the newest games on the homebrew scene, there's sure to be something here for everyone. Download links and installation instructions are included for every game, and we're starting now. The first port on the list features that beloved blue member of the Erinaceidae family, Sonic the Hedgehog. The VPK download for this game is on the GitHub. Scroll down to the Assets section until you see the listing for Sonic 1 and click to download the VPK file. Then on the Mega website, there's a supplemental file that's a zip file that you need to download to work with the game. Click on Sonic 1, then right click and select download to download the necessary file to your computer. Once the file's downloaded, connect your Vita by USB or by FTP to your computer using Vita Shell. Once you go into Vita Shell, you can connect by pressing the select button to either activate FTP or activate the USB connection. In your downloads folder, you'll have the VPK file and a zip file. Extract the contents of the zip file in your downloads folder, and then you can delete the zip file to eliminate clutter. From here, copy the VPK file, then navigate to the location of your Vita on your computer, which is represented as a USB drive, either as the internal storage on a Model 2000 or the original Sony Vita card on a 1000. Then paste the VPK right on the root. Go back to the downloads folder, and you'll have that other folder that says Sonic 1. Right click for copy, then go back to your Vita storage, go into the data folder, and inside the data folder, paste this Sonic 1 folder right here. Now you can close File Explorer and disconnect your Vita from your computer. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel while you're here. You'll get notified of great new content when it's posted. Back on your Vita, in Vita Shell, use the D-pad to scroll down until you get to UX0, then select UX0 with the X button. From here, it's pretty much a straight roll right down to the bottom of the list of files. Look for the one that says Sonic 1 has a VPK extension, select it with X, and press X again to install it. Once the VPK is installed, you're done with Vita Shell. Press the PlayStation button on your Vita, and when prompted, either swipe from the top right down or press and hold the circle button to go back to the Vita Live area. In the Live area, navigate down with the selector to Sonic 1 and select it with the X button, or just tap on it to select the game. Then tap or select with X to launch. From the main menu, select Start Game. Then pick a game save slot that you want to use. In this case, I'll use New Game. Then select the character you want and press X. You'll be greeted with the familiar Sega logo and then the splash screen to start the game. Tap to start the game and you'll be greeted with the familiar Sonic the Hedgehog that we've known and loved for decades. It plays fantastic on the PlayStation Vita. Having the Vita's physical controls makes this game a lot more fun to play on mobile than, say, using the virtual controls on something like Android or iOS. Bearing the simple installation process in mind, let's take a look at the next port. And it's on the same GitHub page where we just left off. This time it's Sonic 2. In the Assets section, go to the link where it says Sonic 2 VPK and click to download the VPK file. And this time on the Mega site, you'll need to download Sonic2.zip. Right click, select download, and download it to your downloads folder. Alright, let's skip the labor pains and get to the baby. I'm sure you know how to do this at this point. Connect your Vita with Vita Shell by USB or FTP, unzip, delete the zip file, grab the VPK file, put it on the root of your Vita's memory card, then grab the folder with Sonic 2, go to the data folder, and paste it in the data folder. Disconnect your Vita from your PC, scroll down to Sonic 2 VPK, select it with X, and select X to install. Then you can close out Vita Shell by pressing the PlayStation button, swipe from the right corner down, or hold circle. You'll see Sonic 2 dancing on your live area. Scroll down to Sonic 2 and select it to launch it. And this time you'll be greeted with Sonic the Hedgehog and his buddy Tails. Pretty cool. What's amazing about these Sonic ports is that they run at nearly full speed and with fantastic gameplay and a minimum of lag, with no overclocking on the part of the Vita. And while you can't get a performance boost from overclocking, it really isn't necessary for the most part with these two games. It has just played fantastic overall. And if you can't get enough of the Blue Hedgehog, check this out. How about the Sonic game widely regarded as the best Sonic game of all time? You can grab Sonic CD on the GitHub by scrolling down to the Assets section and click on the VPK for Sonic CD here. and on the Mega site, navigate to the Sonic CD zip file, right-click, and select Download to download this needed file to your Downloads folder. Same process for installation. Connect your Vita over USB or FTP, unzip the downloaded zip file, delete the zip file, take the VPK file, copy it, post it to the root of the Vita, go back and grab the folder, go to the root of the Vita, go to Data, and paste the folder into the Data folder. Disconnect your Vita from your PC, scroll down to the bottom, find Sonic CD's VPK, press X, and press X to install. Then close out Vita Shell with the PlayStation button, swipe from the right corner down or hold circle, tap or press X to select Sonic CD, then tap or press X to launch the game, and the legendary Sonic CD will be playable at your fingertips. I think it's worth noting here, while the main levels in the game played fantastic even without overclocking, the bonus stages ran significantly slower than they did on the original disc-based game, but I think overclocking will certainly help with this. If games featuring the plumber dressed in blue and red are more your speed, Mario Kart DS Vita is going to be a perfect game for your handheld. Grab the VPK file from the link in the description below. For the rest of the video, every game installs with just a single VPK. Just connect your Vita by USB, grab the VPK file and copy it, go over to your Vita's memory area by USB, and then paste it to the root. Disconnect from USB, scroll down to the VPK, select it with X, then select X again to install. Once the installation is complete, press the PlayStation button on your Vita to close out Vita Shell, then either swipe from the right down or press and hold circle. Make sure Mario Kart is selected, then tap or select it with X, then tap or press X to launch it. This extraordinary port of Mario Kart DS features a number of different racers and a number of different tracks. As a port of the game, it actually has a tremendously smooth frame rate and a responsive set of controls which make racing in this game a lot of fun. If you're a fan of the plumber or racing games, this game is a must-have in your Vita collection. Switching gears to original homebrew games, check out these incredible submissions at the QHEN 2021 competition. The QHEN competition features submissions from talented programmers, all competing for notoriety and cash prizes. To see the downloadable games here, go to the Submissions tab and take a look at this first one called Brain Splitter. Click the Brain Splitter icon, then click the Download button, and at the Download screen, click the large icon shown here to download the VPK file to your Downloads folder. Alright, you know what to do here. Connect your Vita by USB, grab the VPK file from the Downloads folder, go to the root of the storage on the Vita, and paste the VPK file. In Vita Shell, scroll down to the Brain Splitter VPK, select it with X, then select X again to start the install process. Once the installer is done, you can press the PlayStation button and swipe from the right corner down, or press and hold the circle button to go back to the Vita Live area. And from the Live area, select Brain Splitter by tapping on it or selecting with X, then tap or X to launch it. If you're not familiar with Lappy, he's one of the best developers in the indie and homebrew scene for PlayStation Vita. Kudos for making this incredible game. From its comical backstory read by a robot, to its unique premise of literally having two ships split on two separate sides of the screen, controlled by two separate hands on the Vita, this game is one of the most unique and challenging games I've seen in a long time come across the Vita indie scene. You've really got to master this concept of controlling ships on different sides using different sides of your brain, or you'll be seeing this message a lot on your screen. Based on its unique premise, the replayability of this game is just off the charts. If three-dimensional arena shooters are your game, you want to grab Thrust Shot. Click the screen, and then click the Download button to go to the Downloads page. Then click the green icon to download the VPK. One of the great things about the submissions at QHEN is they are contained within a single VPK file. Just copy the VPK file, connect your Vita by USB, navigate to the storage, and paste the VPK right on the root. Then back on your Vita in Vita Shell, navigate to the Thrust Shot VPK, select it with X, then select it with X again to install it to your Vita. Once it's done, press the PlayStation button on your Vita, then swipe from the right corner down or press an old circle to go back to the Live area. Then navigate to Thrust Shot on your Live area, select it with X or tap it, and then X or tap again. One of the things that makes this game so much fun, and the reason it's called Thrust Shot, is you actually have a thruster pack so that you can launch yourself up into the air and climb on the top of buildings or other things to get a tactical advantage. Featuring player versus computer and online multiplayer, this is one of the most ambitious homebrew games for PlayStation Vita. And if a more frantic-paced shooter is more to your liking, you want to get Angel Collide. This game is something else. Click on its icon, go to download, and grab the VPK here. Just the same as the other games, copy the VPK file from downloads, plug in your Vita, and then paste it to the root of your memory card. Then in Vita Shell, navigate down to Angel Collide VPK, select it with the X button, and then press X again to install it. Once it's installed, press the PlayStation button, then swipe from the right corner down or press and hold circle. Then navigate down to Angel Collide on the live area, tap or X, and then tap or X to launch the game. This game is frantic. The instructions say shoot everything that moves, and they're not kidding. You can press and hold the right shift button on the Vita in order to shoot forward, and you can also shoot 360 degrees by moving the right stick around. The game throws everything but the book at you, and if you don't learn how to move and shoot fast, you'll be staring at this game over screen a lot more often than you'd like. If fast-paced shooting action is what you're looking for, this is the game for you. And if you ever wanted to pit major video game executives against each other in a run-and-gun style game to fight it out for supremacy, Super Console Wars is right up your alley. Click the download button, and on the download page, click the download button under PlayStation Vita. This takes you to the Mega site, where you can get the Vita VPK file for this by clicking the green download button and just waiting for a moment until everything loads up and downloads to your downloads folder on your PC. Connect your Vita by USB, right-click on the VPK file, select copy, go to your Vita storage, and paste it right on the root of the storage. Just like the others in Vita Shell, scroll down to the bottom, find the VPK, select it with the X button, and then press X again to install. Once the install process is complete, press the PlayStation button, swipe from the right down, or press and hold circle. And in the live area, navigate down to Super Console Wars, and tap or select it with X, then tap or select to launch the game. One of the things that makes this game fun and really kind of differentiates it in a lot of ways from other run-and-gun games is the amount of thought that you have to put into things. If you mindlessly run forward shooting at things, you'll get trapped into a pit within seconds of starting the game. As run-and-gun games go, this is a thinking player's game. One wrong move and it's game over for you. But if you plan your moves with patience and precision, you'll be rewarded with longevity and exciting gameplay on your PlayStation Vita. Now that you have these games installed on your Vita, why not grab some more? Check out this video here, shown on screen and linked in the pinned comment and description below.